Maybe you've heard some of these musicians and you want to know more about them. Or you've just heard people use this term before and you have no idea what it means or where it came from. Regardless, this is an introduction to PC music. In June of 2013, British music producer and singer A.G. Cook founded a record label called PC Music. He wanted to take on the role of A&R with the main goal of, quote, recording people who don't normally make music and treating them as if they're a major label artist. Within the next year and a half, he dropped 40 songs on SoundCloud, featuring different musicians who would soon become the regular roster of the label. By September of 2014, every single track had over 100,000 listens, and Cook had pretty much created a new subgenre with PC music. The sound I'm describing is this electronic, experimental, highly exaggerated dance pop. It's all very bright and colorful, more often than not featuring female vocals that are sometimes shifted to higher or lower pitches. Also, it's very much a product of the internet age, hence the name PC music. Then, when you least expect it, the songs can transition from cute and angelic to these dark, industrial, noisy tracks. A lot of PC music is dreamlike, but don't be surprised if there are a few nightmares scattered in there too. Just to make this note, while this subgenre of idealistic, cute pop music, which can take a dark turn, is a lot of what PC music makes, it's not all of what they make. The deeper you dive into the label, you'll see that they touch on a variety of genres. If you want to look at the PC music roster for a better understanding of things, that's where it starts to get a little complicated. This isn't really a record label in the same way that RCA or Columbia are record labels. When you look at RCA, Brockhampton is signed to them, Pink is signed to them, Foo Fighters are signed to them, and the list goes on. The musicians have absolutely nothing to do with one another. They make different kinds of music, there will never be a Brockhampton Pink Foo Fighters tour. You get what I mean, they're just signed to the same label, which helps fund their careers and whatnot. But when you look at PC music, it's much more of an abstract kind of thing. PC music is a label, yes, but it's also an art collective of sorts. All of the musicians associated have probably worked with each other at one point or another. A lot of their stuff sounds pretty similar, and that's another thing about PC music, is that you can use the phrase when you're describing the genre of the music that they put out. If I asked you what your favorite genre was, and you said, oh, I like the stuff that RCA puts out, I would have no idea what that means. But if you said, oh, I've been really into PC music lately, I can say, oh, you like this avant-garde, postmodern, bubblegum dance pop music. To complicate things even further, there are a lot of different aliases associated with this label and no concrete list of artists, so it's hard to figure out exactly who's who sometimes, and how many musicians are really attached to this thing. When we go through some of these musicians, you can almost look at them as if they're just art experiments. I know that sounds weird to say, but the identities are so meticulously planned and thought out, so strange and separate from daily human life, that it's hard to figure out what's real and fake. If you know the story of Poppy, you'll understand what I mean. It's more like you're watching a character than an actual person. For fans of the phrase industry plant, this is kind of a funny look into that idea. Some of PC Music's musicians embrace branding and consumerism, advertisements, and they thrive off of it. They want to create the perfect idealistic pop stars, and them being so upfront about it has been polarizing to a lot of people. If you want a perfect example of PC music going hand in hand with branding, look no further than GFOTY, short for Quinn Thomas. This is a character, pop singer, art project, whatever you want to call it. She promotes and is also the living embodiment of a semi-fictional energy drink called Drink GFOTY. The main song that goes along with this character is called Hey GFOTY, and it came out on August 26, 2014. It very much fits into the whole sound of PC music with its dance pop nature, its use of synths, pitch changed vocals, and that kawaii aesthetic. My personal favorite pop star from PC music is probably Hannah Diamond. You can catch her wearing these big puffy coats, looking like a mixture between Cameron and Sporty Spice. Her voice is extremely theatrical, like she's a grown-up version of Annie, and she's a great poster child for the label. Here's a snippet of the sparkly, cyberculture-themed song, Hi. There are a lot of musicians and names to go over if you want to completely immerse yourself in the culture of PC music. GFOTY, short for Girlfriend of the Year, is a pop singer who has since left the label. Some of the main producers associated are founder A.G. Cook, Danny Harley, Kane West is the alias of Gus Loban from Kiro Kiro Bonito, and there's many more. You could even look into much more popular musicians like Charli XCX and Carly Rae Jepsen who have been affiliated with PC music at one point or another. And here's the thing. PC music was popular in 2014 and 2015. By 2016, they had released their two label-wide compilation projects, PC Music Volumes 1 and 2, but since then, we haven't heard a whole lot from them. Except the one member that seemed to rise above the rest, if you will. The only one that's super prominent in the music world in 2019, and that's Sophie.
I'm real when I shop my face.
She's a Scottish producer, singer-songwriter, and DJ, and I think she's one of the most important people in music right now. Her debut album, Oil of Every Pearls on Insides, was one of my favorite projects of last year. It was nominated for a Grammy, and besides that, she's been working a lot recently. She's done production for some pretty high-profile musicians, like Lady Gaga and Vince Staples. Her juxtaposition of lighthearted, cutesy electronic music with darker, more experimental sounds is incredible. Watching her rise, her sound evolving over time, and that sound helping other artists like Charli XCX experiment and change has been so wonderful to see. It's progression, and it's great. And I just have to mention, it's amazing seeing a trans woman in the spotlight. Sophie is such an icon to so many people right now, and it's no wonder why the sort of aura surrounding PC music has always been so positive. They're very inclusive and carefree, there's a lot of LGBTQ love in the fanbase, and that's one of the many reasons why I think this record label, this movement, is so important. Looking back at the PC music camp and all that they have offered, I think they were vital in sparking a little bit of a revolution in pop music. I know there's still a lot of formulaic garbage on the radio, but there's a ton of great, relatively popular music that I've heard over the last few years that seems directly influenced by Sophie, A.G. Cook, and the rest of them. They've brought new life to pop, made a ton of amazing music in the process, and I thank them for that. Hey, thank you so much for watching that video. I'd like to give a special shout out to Lil Dumpling and Nighthawk for helping me write it. If you enjoyed it, feel free to like, comment, and subscribe. That stuff is easy and it helps the channel. Other ways you can support me are through buying my merch and supporting my Patreon. Follow me on social media at RenshawHS, and I'll see you soon. Thanks.